I'm a pianist and a composer. I've been playing piano for about 20 years and composing for that amount of time. I call my genre of music life music, and I love what I do. My name is Justin Levitt.
There are three basic concepts that we came up for this photo shoot, and so the first part of it was pretty cool, is to basically to clone Justin around his piano. And as many of you may know, a lot of creative people get writer's block. As a composer, he gets writer's block. So I wanted him to express those feelings. So around his piano, I'm gonna have up to five of these Justin dudes. And each one of these guys, I want them to somehow connect with one another. So I needed him to, first of all, look in the same direction as the other Justin would be looking. And I used Ivan as a placeholder at the same height that Justin might sit or stand in the other direction. So that way, Justin can get the perfect eye level, so when he looks like he's arguing with himself, it really looks like he's looking at himself in this image. So a lot of things had to come together. One of them was, once I set my light, once you set my exposure and everything, you don't mess with it at all. It's a wrap. That is good. So all you can do is move Justin, which is the subject, and take a picture, and take another picture, and take another picture. And at the end of all that, you take it into Photoshop and you just composite each one of the Justins, making this, I don't know, as he would call it, an alter ego shot. So there's five Justins in this shot in one image. And as I was bringing it into Photoshop, I was looking, I was like, man, something's missing. Something's really missing here. And if you notice inside the body of the piano, the side of the piano, it seemed a little flat and dull to me. So I hope you didn't mind, but I took one of my pictures that I took a while back. It's actually the city at night, San Francisco at night, and I superimposed it on the side, on the body of the piano. I think it came out really good, and I'm hoping he likes it as well. So we'll go from there, and that's the first shot. And then the next scene is pretty cool as well. Back where we were in front of the piano and all of that, I looked to my right, and we have in the hangar with us, we have an airplane. And I wanted to somehow use this airplane in this photo session. So as I'm walking towards the side of the plane, the wing seems to come right at me. And it just dawned on me, why don't we use that as a big keyboard? You know, I could take a picture of his keyboard and superimpose it on this airplane. And I think it'll come out amazing. And so that's what we did. So we had Justin sitting on the side, or standing on the side of the wing, and acting like he was playing. First of all, he was playing like this. I said, well, your hands are really close. I said, that's not gonna work. Because when I stretch this bad boy keyboard, the keys are gonna be far apart. They're not gonna be close together as he was playing. So once he understood that, he actually got into it. And I told him, give me some dramatics, like throw your head back, whatever. And so that was pretty cool. We took the first shot. And I'm saying, man, I still need something. So when you do these kind of photos, you have to build. You start with the basics and then you build from that. And I need to soar more dramatic. So we came up with, what if we just threw some paper in the air, simulating kind of wind going on. And so we tried that and it was really funny. Oksana and Ivan, it was great, but we couldn't do the count. I would say like 3, 2, 1, and then toss paper. For some reason or another, we couldn't sync up together and it was all over the place. But at the end of it, we were able to take the shot. We did capture it. Justin was awesome. He did the dramatic scene because he really got into character, which I really need to really sell these kind of images. And basically when I brought it into post, I put the keyboard on there, added some dramatic, added some lighting, added more of a grungy feel to it. And I put particles in the air because where there's wind, there's dust and all that stuff. And that concludes the second part of the photo shoot. And I think that image came out as well as the first. I think they both came out amazing and I'm looking forward to the next part. Okay, here we are. We're at the final part of the photo shoot. This is like the third scenario. And basically what I want to do, now that the fun stuff's out the way, I wanted to give Justin something that he can actually use on maybe on his next album cover or whatever, advertisement or whatever he may want to use it for. But I wanted to give him something nice, just besides all the cool stuff when all that's said and done. I just needed to give him something nice. So we went back to his piano. And this time I told him there's no dramatics, I don't need no drama, no anime, I just need a simple headshots we're gonna be doing and some faraway shots. I did a couple of black and whites and I think they came out really nice and I put his name across it, so hopefully he likes that little flavor I just added to that. But all in all, I think this was a very successful photo shoot. I had a great time. I know I got carried away. The movers who moved the piano there were waiting outside the hangar, just waiting. So I felt pretty bad. But at the same time, once I get going, I can't stop. I could have done this all day long. But that's another conversation. I had a great time anyways. Justin, I want to say thank you. Thank you. I think this collaboration between me and you, I think it's going to be amazing.